Welcome all of you to my video on market equilibrium. We have done about demand and then we have done about the supply. Demand and supply together constitutes market, and the question is, how does market come to equilibrium? The market equilibrium, the market comes to equilibrium by the producers and the suppliers. They supply the product, so they are on the supply side, and then there are consumers who demand the product, and demanders and suppliers together constitute the market. And there comes the Adam Smith's invisible hand. What is invisible hand? Invisible hand is in fact the market mechanism which brings the market to equilibrium, which in fact decides what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. So coming to market equilibrium, in the market there is surplus when excess quantity is supplied. When there is excess quantity, there will be downward pressure on price. So price comes down, and when price comes down, demanders will demand more or consumers will demand more, and it will come to market will come to equilibrium. Similarly, when there is shortage, excess quantity is demanded. When there is excess quantity, there will be upward pressure on price. The upward pressure on price will increase the quantity supplied. As you know, the law of supply, if price is high, suppliers will supply more, and this will upward pressure on price will increase the quantity supplied, and it will also decrease the quantity of demanded, and finally the both will come to equilibrium. So it is equilibrium when quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied. Plans of buyers and sellers match, that is the equilibrium quantity. So at equilibrium quantity, we have quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied. Market clears, there is no surplus and no shortages and no pressure on price. And the price at which the demand is equal to supply is nothing but the equilibrium price. So we have the pizza market over here. Price of pizza $1.15, quantity demanded is 8 because the price is too high, quantity supply 28, higher the price supply will be more. So there is surplus of 20, and the effect on price is towards the downward direction. There is surplus in the market, and this will put the price down. The price comes to 12. Quantity demanded extends to 14. Quantity supplied will decline to 24, and now there is surplus of only 10. Again, price falls to 9. Now quantity demanded and supplied are equal. It is equilibrium. If we go from the downward direction, if price is $3, then quantity demanded is 32. People will feel that pizzas are very cheap and they will like to demand more of pizzas. But quantity supplied is very less. Suppliers are getting less profit, less price, and so they do not have the motivation to supply more. And there is shortage. Shortage of how much? 32 minus 12, so it is 20. Now, this shortage of 20 will put a upward pressure on the price, and therefore the price will rise. Price will rise to 6. Quantity demanded is 26, quantity supplied 16, there is shortage of again 10, again 26 minus 16, and it will again put an upward pressure on price. So we have the demand curve and the supply curve. Demand curve slopes downwards from the left to right, and supply curve shifts slopes upwards from left to right at price of 9, both demand and supply are equal. So 20-20, and there is equilibrium. At higher price of 12, there is surplus. Suppliers are supplying more while demanders are I'm sorry, while demanders are demanding less and there is surplus, if price is 6 rupees, then demanders are demanding more and suppliers are supplying less, there is shortage. Yes, when there is surplus, there will be downward pressure on price. When there is shortage, there will be upward pressure on price. Now, coming when there is surplus or when there is shortage, it means there is disequilibrium. This disequilibrium will be temporary, because if market is left free, it will come to equilibrium. But sometimes, because of result of government intervention, there may be price floors and price ceilings. So price floors and price ceilings, I will keep it for my next video. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel.